Hello students, we'll continue with chapter light and today we will discuss the BPQs given on page number 194 and then we will do the chapter end exercise. Please read the question given on page 184. Question 1 says, define one dioptere of power of a lens. Students, dioptere is the SI unit of power of a lens. Therefore, one dioptere can be defined as the power of a lens whose focal length is 1 meter. Question number 2 says, a convex lens forms a real and inverted image of a needle at a distance of 50 cm from it. Where is the needle placed in front of the convex lens if the image is equal to the size of the object? Also find the power of the lens. Students, in the question it is given that the image of the needle is formed at a distance of 50 cm from it, and it is also given that the size of the image is equal to the size of the object. Now, since the size of the image is equal to the size of the object, which is possible when the object is kept at twice of focal length. When the object is just at 2f1, its image is formed at 2f2, and the size of the image and the size of the object are equal. Moreover, the distance of the object from the lens is also equal to the distance of the image from the lens. Therefore, since the distance of the image from the lens is 50 cm, the distance of the object from the lens will also be 50 cm. Therefore, the needle is placed in front of the lens at a distance of 50 cm. Now, we have to calculate the power of the lens. Here u we have, that is minus 50, v is plus 50. Focal length we can find. By finding the focal length, we can find the power of the lens. And we can easily find the focal length using the lens formula, that is 1 by v minus 1 by u is equal to 1 by f. Substitute the value of u and v, you will get your focal length, that is 25 cm. Now, in order to find the power, we need to have focal length in meters. So convert 25 cm to meter, that is 0.25 meters. Power is equal to 1 by f. 1 upon 0.25 is equal to plus 4 dioptere. 1 divided by 0.25 is plus 4. So the power is plus 4 dioptere. In third question, he wants you to calculate the power of a concave lens of focal length 2 meters. Students, concave lens has negative focal length. Therefore, focal length of concave lens will be minus 2 meters. Power of lens is given by the formula 1 by f. So, power is 1 upon minus 2, which is minus 0.5 dioptere. Now, we will do the chapter end exercise. And the question 1 of this exercise says, which of the following materials cannot be used to make a lens? Water, glass, plastic or clay. Water, glass and plastic, students, will allow light to pass through them. Therefore, they can be used to make a lens. Whereas clay cannot be used to make a lens because light will not pass through it. So, the correct answer is D. In question number 2, the image formed by a concave mirror is observed to be virtual, erect and larger than the object. What should be the position of the object? Option A, between the principal focus and center of curvature. Option B, at the center of curvature. Option C, beyond the center of curvature. Option D, between the pole of the mirror and its principal focus. Students, since the image is virtual, erect and larger than the object, which is only formed in the sixth case, that is between when the object is between P and F. When the object is between P and F of the concave mirror, then the image formed is virtual, erect and larger. Therefore, option D is correct. Now, the third question, where should be an object be placed in front of a convex lens to form a real image of the same size? Students, since it is a real image and is of the same size of the object, so the object must be kept at twice of focal length. So the option B is correct. That is, the object should be placed at twice of focal length in order to get an image of the same size of the object. We'll proceed to question 4 now. A spherical mirror and a thin spherical lens have a focal length of minus 15 cm. The mirror and the lens are likely to be both concave, both convex. The mirror is concave and the lens is convex. The mirror is convex and the lens is concave. Students, both the lens and the mirror must be concave because the focal length is negative. Concave mirror and concave lens both have negative focal length. So your option A is correct. Please read question number 5. No matter how far you stand from a mirror, your image appears erect. The mirror is likely to be a plane mirror, a concave mirror, a convex. Option D, either plane or a convex. Students, irrespective of the object distance, both plane mirror as well as your convex mirror forms virtual image, which is always erect. Right, students? Therefore, option D is correct, that is either plane or convex.